In the previous videos, you have learned to create a FlexBee behavior with available state implementations. But it is actually very common that you have developed a robot capability that is specific to your application. For example, to start and stop the conveyor belt in our factory simulation. So, to include this capability in your behaviors, you need to develop your own state implementation. In this unit, we will learn how to do that and create FlexBee state implementations. First, let's remember what is a FlexBee state. On Unit 3.2 this week, we said that a FlexBee state is the use of a capability in our raw system to perform a specific action. For example, the move robot 1 to pick state in our demo uses the move group to move the robot to a specific configuration. Let's dig a bit deeper on this idea and what it implies regarding state implementations in FlexBee. Okay, we can say that FlexBee follows a design principle that is very important in ROS, separating your application-specific behavior from the robot capabilities. This principle guarantees that you can use the same ROS nodes for different applications. For example, as you have seen, the move base and move group nodes are used in many different robot applications for mobile manipulators and for mobile robots. What does this principle mean for FlexBee states? Well, it means that the state implementations should be interfaces to the nodes that implement the capabilities. That is, in practice, a FlexBee state is internally implemented as a client that requests the specific action. This means that the state implementations should in general be simple, including little computation. For example, let's come back to the robot motions in our pick behavior. The move group node provides different interfaces for the capability to move a robot manipulator. So a state implementation would only need to consist of a client of that capability. Well, this is exactly what the move it to join dyne state implementation that we have used is. It is basically an action client that sends a goal with the join configuration to the move group node and monitor the result of the execution. In our move robot 1 to pick, a concrete goal is sent with the join configuration compute for the grasping. Following this design principle, the capabilities remain generic. They can be used multiple times in our state machine. For example, in our state machine, we use another state of the class move it to join dyne state. This time, to send the robot goal to move to the robot 1 home configuration. But moreover, by making the states independent of the nodes that implement the robot capabilities, we make sure that we can use those ROS nodes in other applications. Okay, so let's now remember the properties of FlexBee states we studied in the previous module. The state parameters, input and output keys, and the outcomes define from an external viewpoint how the state performs and what data it processes for that reason in our concrete behavior. That is, they are the external interface the state implementation offers to particularize it for a specific behavior. So, to sum up, what should a FlexBee state implementation contain? Well, we have seen that internally, it should execute a specific robot operation by implementing a client to an available robot capability. On the other hand, it has to provide an external interface that allows to configure the state for different behaviors by accepting different values for its parameters, connecting to runtime data through input and output keys, and defining a set of possible outcomes of that state. So, the question, if we want to create our own state implementation, is how do we implement all this? The answer is the FlexBee state lifecycle that we will discuss in the next video.